My name is Rocky Heron. I spent 31 years as a special agent for the DEA, the United States Drug Enforcement Administration. Trying to stop drug traffickers at the local, national, and international levels.
And this is us getting stuck in the piranha and alligator infested waters.
I saw too many beautiful people just like you lose their lives or the quality of their lives because they didn't understand the consequences of abusing drugs and alcohol. Today, I use those experiences as a basis for teaching young people like you the hard truth about what substance abuse will do to you and your dreams and your futures, hoping that some of you are listening and that some of you will make better choices. Today, we'll talk about four different types of drugs and how they affect the mind and body of the people who use them. While each substance impacts the body differently, they all share the potential to harm you emotionally and physically and to change the course of your life. It is very important for you to remember that your brain chemistry is unique to you, and none of you know what these drugs will do to you personally before you use them. Only one thing is certain: there are no long-term benefits. There are hundreds of different types of drugs that you could choose to put in your bodies. New ones are being invented daily. We don't have time to discuss them all, but we're going to talk about some of the major ones. The four major types of drugs are stimulants like cocaine, methamphetamine, and ecstasy, or depressants like alcohol, or prescription drugs like Valium and Xanax, hallucinogens like marijuana, PCP, and LSD, and finally, opioids. Drugs like fentanyl, heroin, and OxyContin. All of these are psychoactive drugs that change how your brain and other body functions occur. Some drugs, such as nicotine, caffeine, cocaine, marijuana/THC, and heroin, come from chemicals found naturally in plants. Other drugs are completely synthetic, which means they're made only from dangerous chemicals and have no natural basis. Unfortunately, many young people believe that if the drugs come from plants, they are, quote, natural, and therefore somehow harmless or safe to use. That's ridiculous. Some of those most dangerous poisons in the world come from plants. Nicotine is a poison in the tobacco plant that protects it from insects. Plenty of plants and mushrooms will kill you instantly if you put them in your body. All of the drugs I'm going to discuss today have killed far too many people just as beautiful and special as you are. None of us will ever know what drugs will do to us before we start using them. Now, let's take a closer look at those four types of drugs I mentioned. Stimulants speed up the central nervous system, they speed up the heart, they increase blood pressure, and they often make the users appear hyperactive. Weak stimulants, like caffeine and nicotine, are legal and are found in coffee and cigarettes. Stronger stimulants, however, are illegal because of the negative impacts on the people who use them. Cocaine is a powerful stimulant that is obtained from the chemicals in the leaves of the coca plant grown in countries like Bolivia, Peru, and Colombia. Cocaine is usually used in a powder or to smoke as crack. It causes a very powerful addiction, and the effects are so strong in the body that it causes some users to have heart attacks, even sometimes from the first use. But that shiny white powdered cocaine that shows up at your party is made from really nasty toxic chemicals. That pit is full of acids and solvents. When they are done making that cocaine, do you think they dispose of those chemicals in an environmentally sound way? No, of course they don't. They dump them into the ground and water of the countries where it is made. I spent 6 years searching for and burning down cocaine labs when I worked for DEA in Bolivia. I would find the labs and burn them down. Burn them down, and burn them down, and burn them down. I saw how toxic the chemicals were and how much those labs damaged the natural environment. Methamphetamine is a very powerful central nervous system stimulant being produced in enormous quantities in Mexico. It's one of the worst drugs I've ever seen for the way it impacts the people who use. People start using it to feel strong and powerful, but over time it has very toxic effects on all of their bodies and their minds. I seized too much of this poison in my career, and I had to see what it did to the people who chose to use it. Meth is less expensive to make than cocaine, and that is one of the reasons it is so widely used. People can take more of it for less money. It is produced illegally in clandestine laboratories by drug dealers who are not scientists. There is no quality control, no science going on. They're just making chemicals to sell to you, and they don't care what they do to you or your life. These are the laboratories where the drugs are made. There is no science here, no cleanliness, no quality control, just idiot drug dealers mixing toxic chemicals together to make a drug they can sell to you. They don't even always know what's in it. So how could you know what's in it before you put it in your body? I want you to hear from another friend of mine, someone who has spent her life seeing the toxic chemicals and the drug labs. Jennifer Harmon is a scientist who runs the San Diego County Sheriff's Department Regional Crime Lab.
I have seen drug labs in person, and they're really not very a clean, sterile environment. I've been in forensics for 23 years, and my technical expertise is actually as a toxicologist. In terms of drug prevalence in San Diego County, methamphetamine is our most prevalent drug in terms of the drugs that are seized by our officers and that come here to have testing done. I think when you're talking to young people about illicit drugs, including methamphetamine, it's just really important for them to know that these are narcotics that are made from all sorts of different chemicals. They're not made in sterile environments. A lot of times they're in the back of houses or garages or even outside. It's not tested in terms of ensuring that it's safe for people to consume. And so it's important to know that these things are dangerous and not good for you. They're toxic chemicals.
Sadly, many of the users of drugs who take them to feel strong and positive and to escape from their problems discover that over time, those drugs take control and break them down. These are all pictures of real people who thought meth would help improve their lives. None of these people thought they would be in my presentation when they started using meth. But here they are. All of them are someone's child, husband, or wife, or parent. Ecstasy is a street name for MDMA, methylene dioxy methamphetamine, a synthetic drug that comes from the same toxic chemicals as methamphetamine. It has always been marketed to young people as a cool party drug, but it often kills young people by causing their brain cells to break down. At the party, it will always come in the pretty pill to make you think it's cool and safe. Ecstasy is similar to meth and comes from the same types of nasty chemicals and toxic, dangerous laboratories. It causes the body to speed up and the brain to overheat. The chemicals it causes the brain to produce prevent the brain from protecting itself. Sadly, many of the young people who die from ecstasy do so because their brains just get too hot. It's horrible. The drug dealers can make pills from anything, give them a pretty color, and promise you they're safe and good. Opioids are drugs that can have amazing benefits for people who are in pain. But those same drugs can have very devastating consequences in the people who take them to get high and for fun. Thousands of years ago, humans discovered that certain poppy plants had the chemicals that helped produce pain. Eventually, scientists were able to produce strong drugs like opium, morphine, heroin, and codeine from those poppy plants. Centuries ago, those natural-based opioids were found to be extremely addictive and destructive. In the last 100 years, scientists developed synthetic opioids made just from chemicals. Those synthetic opioids can be hundreds or even thousands of times stronger and more addictive than the chemicals that came from that original poppy plant. Oxycodone, or Oxy, is a synthetic opioid sold in pharmacies as a painkiller. When it was first sold, the company promised us that it wasn't addictive or dangerous. Sadly, it has proven to be one of the ugliest and deadliest drugs ever sold in the United States. People got it in prescriptions and quickly became addicted, or they thought they could use it for fun and it would be safe because it came from a pharmacy. Lean, which is made from codeine, is considered a quote, party drug, which is really sad for me. Many musicians and people in popular culture sing and talk about this drug as if it were completely harmless. Codeine is an opioid that comes from pharmacies with a prescription, and when used as prescribed, is pretty safe. But lean is when people take that codeine from a pharmacy and mix it with soda and sugary drinks. The risk of overdosing from lean is lower than from Oxy, heroin, or fentanyl. But many of the users of lean move on to use the stronger opioids. In Chapter 6, we're going to discuss fentanyl in more detail. Fentanyl is a synthetic opioid that is about 50 times stronger than heroin. It takes only 2 milligrams of fentanyl to kill an average adult. We're talking just a few grains that fit on the tip of a pencil. So yes, that amount right there is enough to kill you. Fentanyl is mostly sold in pills that look like they came from a pharmacy to trick you into thinking they are safe. These pills we seized in the DEA, and we thought they were from pharmacies. But our DEA laboratory tested them and proved it was all fentanyl. It also comes in a powder that is often sold as heroin. We don't know why, but drug dealers are mixing fentanyl into other drugs they sell, like cocaine and methamphetamine. And the people who use it end up dying from fentanyl. There are 2 main risks from all opioids: addiction and death. Living a life of misery and pain, or dying because a drug dealer gave you too much. It's really unfortunate that opioids are able to help us so much when we're in pain and we use them properly, and yet they'll destroy us so completely if we use them for the wrong reasons. Depressants are drugs that slow down the central nervous system. Major effects of depressants include slower brain speed, slower reactions, loss of coordination, dizziness, and lower blood pressure. Examples of depressants are alcohol and the prescription drugs like Xanax and Valium. Alcohol is probably the most widely consumed drug in history. It is a powerful psychoactive drug that is in beer, wine, and in stronger forms like vodka, tequila, and whiskey. It's legal for people over 21 years old in the US. In the United States, the government estimates that more than 140,000 people die every year as a consequence of alcohol consumption. Alcohol causes destructive liver disease, cancers, drunk driving collisions, and it absolutely contributes to domestic violence and child abuse, as far too many of you know. Alcoholism, the serious addiction to alcohol, contributes to too many of the social problems in our world. I know that many of you have been impacted by the alcoholism of someone close to you. Many people today suffer from anxiety and depression and are prescribed medicines such as Valium, Xanax, Ambien, and others to treat those serious conditions. Millions benefit from taking these drugs as prescribed. If you are, take them as your doctor tells you. Sadly, many people think that because they're prescribed drugs, they must be safe to take for fun or just to get high. Prescription drugs can help people tremendously when taken properly and can destroy them completely when taken for the wrong reasons. These drugs are highly addictive, and when they're combined with other drugs like alcohol and marijuana, they can have very serious impacts on the users, up to and including overdose death. Today, in the world around you, almost all of the pills that show up at the party or at the friend's house that look like they came from a pharmacy are in fact fakes made from fentanyl. If you are handed a pill at a party, you must assume the worst. Hallucinogens are also known as the psychedelic drugs. They distort the perceptions of the people who use them and can cause hallucinations, which mean people see or hear things that aren't real. Some types of hallucinogens are plant-based, like marijuana and mushrooms. Others are synthetic, like LSD and PCP, and are made from horribly dangerous chemicals. While people take these drugs because they're looking for a positive high, often these drugs create a nightmare for the users. One young person told me that she used LSD once in college and it, quote, broke her brain. Mushrooms are a natural fungus that seems safe to many young people because we also eat mushrooms. But in nature, many mushrooms are deadly poisonous, and people around the world die all the time because they mistakenly ate the wrong mushrooms. Some mushrooms also have chemicals that can cause powerful hallucinations. Like every other drug I'm telling you about, maybe the mushrooms your drug dealer or friend offer you are safe, maybe they're not. Maybe you'll have a good ride, or you'll have a terrible nightmare ride. The marijuana plant is a beautiful bush that is found in many varieties all over the world. It contains hundreds of chemicals, but the 2 most famous ones are THC and CBD. THC is the drug people use to get high. CBD is being used and studied for its medical benefits and does not cause people to get high. Like every other drug I'm telling you about, using mushrooms and other hallucinogens is no different than rolling dice. There's a good chance you will get an outcome that you didn't want, a nightmare. In the natural marijuana plant, the concentration of THC is about 4% potency. The marijuana that Bob Marley smoked was about that potent. The marijuana available to you today, however, is much, much stronger. It is not the same weed, not at all. It comes from hybrid plants that produce 25% or more THC, or from THC that has been extracted from the plant with other chemicals and is often more than 90% potent. It is no longer that natural plant that the marijuana business tells you it is. Marijuana is a powerful and addictive drug that is negatively impacting millions of young people just like you all over the world. It changes how young brains develop and is strongly associated with severe mental illness in young users. I will talk much more about marijuana in Chapter 5. Around the world, scientists are searching for new ways to help people with serious mental health and physical illnesses. You might see headlines today talking about medical studies using ecstasy or mushrooms to help people. I hope those new medical studies do find better ways to help people, even with drugs that have been famous as drugs of abuse. The problem, however, is that many young people see those headlines as they circulate on social media or TikTok, and too many young people decide that those drugs must be safe for them too. But let's be real. The drugs being used in those medical studies are being produced by scientists and administered by doctors who are carefully looking out for the people using them. You choosing to go down the block or choosing to go online to buy some mushrooms or ecstasy or whatever, you're not doing the same thing at all. You will not be consuming a drug produced by scientists. You will not be getting the drug from doctors, and no one's going to be looking out for you as you use it. All of the drugs that I've just discussed can lead to addiction or death. There are many, many more drugs that you could choose to put in your bodies, but I don't have time to talk about all of them in this video. You need to make the decision if it's worth the risk. Is entering a lifetime of addiction worth getting high for a few hours? Is getting high with some friends or at home worth the risk of dying? Every person I've ever met who is in substance abuse recovery tells me they wish they hadn't started. They tell me it wasn't worth it. In the next chapter, I'll discuss nicotine, marijuana, and vaping. Remember, none of us knows how drug abuse will impact us before we start. You choose your futures.